Hello children, welcome to e-learning class. This is your English teacher Ganga Bandwal. Children, today we are going to study causative verbs. Causative verbs are have, get, make and let. So, without wasting time, let's start the topic. Children, first of all, we are going to see the definition of causative verbs. Causative verbs convey that someone causes someone else to perform an action. They help establish a causal relationship between the participants in a sentence. Children, we use a causative verb when we want to talk about something that someone else did for us or for another person. It means that the subject caused the action to happen but didn't do it himself or herself. Maybe he or she paid or asked or persuaded the other person to do it. For example, we can say, I cleaned my house. This means I cleaned my house myself. But if I pay someone to clean it, of course I can say, a cleaner cleaned my house. Students, another way to use a causative construction means the same sentence can be said using a causative construction. You can also say, I had my house cleaned. I had my house cleaned means somebody cleaned my house. Okay. So children, let's see the causative verbs are have, which means to hand over the task to someone else. Get, which means to persuade or motivate someone to do something. Let, which means to allow or permit. And make, which means to force someone to do something. Okay, so let's see. The first one is have. Structure 1. Have plus object plus past participle. Children, structure is written here to frame the sentence using causative verb have. We follow this structure. Past participle means third form of verb. We usually use this structure when we are talking about paying someone to do something for us. It is often used for services. Okay. The form is subject plus have plus object plus third form of verb or past participle. You may see the examples. I had my car washed. Means I didn't do it myself. I didn't do it by myself. I told somebody to wash my car. Okay. Next example. John will have his house painted. Okay, children. Let's see structure 2. Have plus person plus bare infinitive. Bare infinitive means infinitive without to. We can also use the construction subject plus have plus person plus bare infinitive. This has a very similar meaning to the first structure, which we have already talked about, but this time we say who did the thing. We talk about the person whom we asked to do the thing for us. So let's see the example. I had the electrician look at my broken light. Second one, next example, the doctor will have the nurse call the patients. So children, let's see the next one, that is get. Structure 1, get plus object plus past participle. Children, we can also use subject plus get plus object plus past participle. This has the same meaning as have, but
it is less formal. Let's see these examples. The students get their essays checked. Next one, I'll get my hair cut next week. Next one, he got his washing machine fixed. Okay, let's see structure 2. Children, we can also use the construction get plus someone plus full infinitive. Full infinitive means infinitive with 2. This you have studied in your grammar book in the chapter infinitives. Okay, full infinitive is given there. You may revise once more. Again, this means that you cause the other person to do the action. Maybe by paying them to do it, or by asking them to do it, or by persuading them to do it. Okay, let's see the examples. She gets her son to do his homework by promising him ice cream when he has finished. I got the cleaner to clean under the cupboards. So children, we have seen get also. Let's see the next one, that is make. Children, let's see the structure which is written here. First of all, we write the subject, then after make, then object, then bare infinitive. Bare infinitive means infinitive without 2. So make can mean force someone to do something. Let's see these examples. His mother made him clean his room. The teacher made us study very hard. Students, if we use make in the passive form, we use the infinitive with 2 instead of the bare infinitive. Let's see these examples. She was made to work on Saturday even though she hated working at weekends. Children, we can also use subject plus make plus object plus adjective. It means to cause the object to be the adjective. That adjective can be good or bad. Let's see the examples. Her story made me really happy. Next one, the traffic jam made us late. Children, let's see next one, that is let. The structure is, first of all, you will write the subject, then let, then object, then bare infinitive, which means infinitive without 2. So let can mean allow or give permission. Let's see these examples. David's mother let him use her car. Next one, our boss let us leave early. Children, we can also use let to mean allow in the sense of make something possible. As you can see, the example is written here. You can buy a pass which lets you visit all the art galleries more cheaply. So children, till now we have seen all the causative verbs. Let's have a look on them once again. First one was have, next one was get, next one was make, and next one was let. Hope you understood it very well. Children, keep studying. Stay safe. Thank you.